Just minutes ago, President Trump was on the South Lawn of the White House holding the event that he staged in lieu of the one originally scheduled to honor the Super Bowl champion Philadelphia Eagles. Most of the Philadelphia Eagles had no intention of attending the White House celebration, a member of the team tells me. So last night, after President Trump heard that so few Eagles were willing to come, he canceled the whole event. Mr. Trump then claimed that the Eagles were not attending because, quote, they disagree with their president because he insists that they proudly stand for the national anthem, hand on heart, in honor of the great men and women of our military and the people of our country, unquote. Now, according to the member of the Eagles with whom I spoke, that claim by President Trump is a lie. This player tells me that not one Eagle cited the president's view on anthem protests when discussing the reasons they did not want to attend. And in point of fact, not once during the regular or postseason did any members of the Philadelphia Eagles kneel during the national anthem. Not once. Now, it's true that one player knelt during preseason, but he was cut. And team captain and safety Malcolm Jenkins did raise his fist several times during the anthem to protest racial inequality and police brutality. But Jenkins never knelt. Now, once the fact that none of the Eagles ever knelt was pointed out to President Trump, he tweeted, quote, staying in the locker room for the playing of our national anthem is as disrespectful to our country as kneeling. Sorry. Yeah, that was the Steelers, the Pittsburgh Steelers, who stayed in the locker room during the anthem, Mr. President. It was not the Philadelphia Eagles. Again, the suggestion that it was the Eagles who did that. False. Deceptive. A lie. This afternoon, the White House launched a third attack on a football team. White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders claiming, quote, the vast majority of the Eagles team decided to abandon their fans, unquote. I know a few Eagles fans who would hotly dispute that. But either way, minutes ago, Sanders launched yet another White House attack, accusing the Eagles of staging a, quote, political stunt because they told the White House rather late in the game that so few players wanted to come. Now, this does all come in a context. The context of former First Lady Barbara Bush and current Senator John McCain not wanting President Trump to attend their funerals. The context of this bizarre new era where most of a Super Bowl winning team does not want to visit the President of the United States. So why? Why did so many Eagles want to skip the event? I asked that member of the team and he told me, quote, reasons vary from player to player because the president gives people so many reasons not to want to go. Lots of guys who are white and even conservative balked at the possibility of going, unquote. A nod in that statement, you'll notice, to the racial realities here. Blacks comprised about three quarters of the Super Bowl winning Eagles team. Malcolm Jenkins, one of the most active players in the social justice movement, told Philadelphia Magazine before the 2016 election that among, quote, the reasons that I didn't like Trump, he says borderline racist things and says crazy things about women, unquote. In February of this year, after the Super Bowl, now former Eagles wide receiver Torrey Smith said this to Don Lemon.
If I told you that I was invited to a party by an individual that I believe is sexist or it has no respect for women, or I told you that this individual has said offensive things towards many minority groups, and I don't feel comfortable by it. This individual also called my peers and my friends SOBs. You would understand why I wouldn't want to go to that party. So why is it any different when this person has the title of President of the United States?
Defensive end Chris Long was raised in Charlottesville, Virginia. He expressed horror at President Trump's response to the Nazis and white supremacists who marched there, tweeting, quote, the lack of condemnation of said groups is either a calculated omission to pander to an ugly corner of our country, or he agrees with those folks, unquote. He has long opposed any White House visit.
My son grows up, and I believe the legacy of our president is going to be what it is. I don't want him to say, hey, Dad, why'd you go when you knew the right thing was to not go?
Now, the Eagles, who are on the record about their issues with the president, they've made it clear that they believe President Trump seeks to divide, not to unite the American people. In the interest of full disclosure, I should tell you, if you don't already know, I'm from Philly. I'm a huge fan of the Eagles, all of them, the ones who wanted to go to the White House and the ones who didn't want to go to the White House. But far more than being a fan of any sports team, I am a huge fan of the truth. When you look at this controversy, when you look at the president lying about the Eagles taking a knee during the anthem, when you look at falsely suggesting the Eagles stayed in the locker room, when you look at the White House press secretary paid with your tax dollars attacking the team over and over. Ask yourself, when members of the Philadelphia Eagles say the president seeks to divide us, are they wrong?